Morning children, this is your English teacher Pallavi Chauhan. I welcome you all to the online English class in this new session. So let's begin with the first lesson from your Beehive book, namely The Fun They Had. Children, really this story is quite interesting and it is set in the future which will make you all love your school. Here the writer wants you all to imagine that how the children feels when there will be no schools, no books and even no friends. Then it means the children, they will be only accompanied by the machines, that is the mechanical teachers, either in the form of the computers or the internet, from where they will learn sitting at their home. So before going to start the story, let me introduce little bit. Here the two central characters are Margie, a 11-year-old girl, and Tommy, who is 13-year-old boy, and they both are discussing on a book which they found, one old book, about the present school, now ours, and the schools in the future. So they discuss a lot, and what result they found at the last, that we will come to know after reading the story. So children, I will be reading the story now paragraph wise and then explaining it simultaneously. So be with me now through the whole story. So let me start from your book, The Fun They Had. Before you read the story, we shall read is set in the future when books and schools as we now know them will perhaps not exist. How will children study then? The diagram below may give you some ideas. You can see children, here in the diagram, the schools of the future are being seen. The children will be learning through virtual classroom, learning through computers, through robotic teachers and moving e-text. Virtual means not real. Okay, not real means the children, they won't have the real classrooms, but they will have the machines, either computers or e-textbooks in front of them for studying. So below that you can see two questions are given over there, discussion questions. I hope you will be able to do it, think over it and try to write it in your notes. Starting with the first paragraph, Margie even wrote about it that night in her diary on the page headed 17th May 2157. She wrote, "Today, Tommy found a real book. It was a very old book. Margie's grandfather once said that when he was a little boy, his grandfather told him that there was a time when all stories were printed on paper. They turned the pages, which were yellow and crinkly. And it was awfully funny to read words that stood still instead of moving the way they were supposed to on a screen, you know. And then when they turned back to the page before, it had the same words on it that it had had when they read it the first time." So children, let's try to understand what's given over there. Margie, who was the 11-year-old girl, she had a very good habit of maintaining her own diary. So she writes about that in her diary that night on the page headed, which date you see children? 17th May 2157. Okay, now we are living in 2020 and here the date is a century ahead from now, so the story is in future, remember that. So she writes on this date that today Tommy found a real book. So it was very old book and Margie's grandfather once had said that to Margie that when he was a little boy, his grandfather, means Margie's grandfather's grandfather, used to read all the stories which were printed on the paper. It means children, just you can see, it's our situation being said here when we are reading using the books, okay, which are printed on the paper. So now they started turning the pages of that old book which Tommy had found. and they found that the pages had turned yellowish in color and they were a little bit crushed also because the book was very old of the ancestors. And they both had fun to read the words that stood still in this book without moving. Okay, as they wished that the words should move as they move on their television screens. Children, as I told, this is set in future where these two children, they used to sit in front of their computers and study. So there we found the words are moving. Yeah, but here the book which they found, there the words were still and they were not moving. And one more thing is that when they turned back to the page before which they had already read, they found the same words which they had read the first time. What happens with us? The page which we have already read, and again when we will turn and go back to that page, we will find the same matter or the content. It won't change as like in the computers. So both of them, they got astonished to see how funny it is for them that the words were not moving and still in that book. Coming to the next para, "Gee," said Tommy, "what a waste. When you are through with the book, you just throw it away. I guess our television screen must have had a million books on it and it's good for plenty more. I wouldn't throw it away." "Same with mine," said Maggie. She was 11 and hadn't seen as many telebooks as Tommy had. He was 13. She said, "Where did you find it?" "In my house," he pointed without looking, because he was busy reading In the Attic. "What's it about?" "School." So here in the second para, we can see one expression, "Gee," from Tommy. Why? Because according to him, this real book which was in his hand was really a wastage. Because according to him, once the book is read, then after it is of no use and it will be thrown away, he thinks. But according to him, the television screen which he uses now, it can have million more books and many more, as many as he wants to read. He can get it on his screen, and that also they won't be thrown away. As you know, children, the contents on the screen, so they are always there, no need to remove it from there. Okay, so Margie also agreed with Tommy that same condition was with her. Here it is mentioned she was 11 years old and she was little younger than Tommy because Tommy was 13 years old. Okay, so she hadn't seen as many telebooks as Tommy had seen. Now she just inquires that from where Tommy found that book. So Tommy was busy reading the book. So without looking at her, just he said that he found the book from the storeroom. Attic means the storeroom in his house. So Margie got curious to know that what was the matter in the book. So Tommy replied that it was all about the